friends. So I made a video that hopefully you have checked out, which is for upper body work with small weights, small dumbbells, 2 or 3 pounds. And I wouldn't even really go heavier than that. But if you don't have weight at home, then here are a few exercises that you can do for your upper body strength without weight. So it's just body weight. And these are gonna be exercises that are a little different. We all know what push-ups are. So these are a little variations from that, so you don't have to only rely on push-ups in your workout. Those are great too, especially tricep push-ups. Excellent for the backs of the arms. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna start with a little plank work, which always works your shoulders and your upper back. And then we'll do some variations on some tricep work, and then we will come back to finishing with some plank work. All right, so let's start in high plank. And we're gonna start right away with getting our heart rate up a little bit, getting our blood pumping with some mountain climbers and some jumping jacks. So first, feel your high plank out, and I'll give you options. So if this isn't working for you, being here in high plank, remember you can drop your knees, and your alternate option for mountain climbers is from your knees to just take it at your own pace and do a cross here. So bring one knee across to the opposite elbow. If you can do your mountain climbers on your toes, then do them on your toes. Option for jumping jacks then would be just to step out one at a time, or even if you're on your toes, maybe you're stepping out one at a time. All right, so we're just gonna do, let's say 8 reps of these. Everything's gonna be pretty short with these. So we'll start with the mountain climbers. Get into position here, and we're gonna go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Switch to jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take a little break if you like. Come back to your child's pose. Breathe. And the next one we will alternate. So we'll do 4 mountain climbers and 4 jumping jacks, 4 plank jacks. All right, so come back to plank and let's go for 4, 3, 2, 1 and 4, 3, 2, 1. Do it again. 4, 3, 2, 1 and 4, 3, 2, 1 and rest. Come back and breathe. And now we cut it in half again. So now just 2 and 2. But we're gonna stick with our 8 reps total, right? So last time, coming back to plank, and we're gonna go for 2, 1, and 2, 1. Do it again. 2, 1, again. 2, 1, last time. 2, 1, and break. So you're getting excellent core work from this as well, but hopefully you do feel that work in your shoulders. All right, that's just to start. We're gonna switch now to some shoulder taps, and then we'll make our way to side planks. So shoulder taps, same idea in starting in high plank, and you can do this on your knees, and you're just tapping opposite shoulder with your hand coming back to plank. You tap, 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 tap. On your toes or your knees.
Keep going. Keep going. And we're going for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and that was the last one of those. Again, excellent shoulder work. It makes you put the pressure from one shoulder to the other and work them alternating. Okay, what do we have next? We're going to make our way to side plank. Again, core work for your obliques. You're getting two and one here. I'm going to come down to forearms and open up into our forearm side plank. You can extend that top arm if you like. And we're just going to hold here, maybe come to your feet, and you can stagger those feet. Or you can stack them and hold shoulders over the elbow. Beautiful job. And then we're going to add some rotators. We rotate under and we open. Under and open. For just 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one, and lower down. Before we switch to the other side, we are actually going to do some what are called one-arm push-ups. Okay, so to do this, I'm going to bend my knees. You don't have to have them all the way out. I am going to come down onto this bottom arm. I'm not going to use this bottom arm, so I'm just going to keep it loose. I can maybe loosely wrap it. The arm that's doing the push-up is the one on top. And you'll see, this is actually really wonderful for working this one side and then the other. So we're gonna push ourselves up with that arm and then drop down. And up and down. And I'm using just the strength of that arm to pull myself up for 5, 4, woo, 3, 2, and last one, push. Oof. Oh my gosh. See, you don't need weight, just your body. All right, we're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So we're gonna set ourselves up in our side plank first. So again, make sure you've got that alignment, shoulder just above the elbow, and we're gonna hold it first. So either come to your knees and you can stay here and stay here for the rotators, or stagger or stack your feet. Keep those hips lifted as you hold and breathe here. Come to a moment of stillness where you feel like everything's perfectly floating. Then add your rotators for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, you reach under, 3, 2, and open up, last one, and drop back down. Good. All right, let's try these one-arm push-ups on this side. So just bend your knees, soft knees. Let your bottom arm relax. Maybe just wrap it around your waist just so you know that you're not using it. And just 8 little push-ups here. And you might find one side is stronger than the other. 8, 7, 6. For me, it's this side. 5, 4, 3, 2, last one, push, woo, and relax. Okay, let's roll ourselves up. And let's take a moment to just roll through those shoulders. Maybe
forward. Okay, I'm gonna give you a few more exercises. Next, we're gonna actually be seated. And we're going to start with some tricep dips. You may have done these off of a chair. You can do these off of a chair or a bench. You can also do these here on the mat. Hands are just behind. Fingers point towards your butt. And feet are hip distance apart. We're gonna lift, so we're hovering that butt off of the floor. And really just lift those hips to as high as you feel comfortable. And then from here, we are dipping down. And see those triceps are bending, the elbows are bending, pointing back. And we're lifting back up for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And come back down. And remember, you can do these many more than 8. I'm just showing you the options so I can show you a bunch of different things. Okay, we can do now the same thing, but we can kick the legs at the same time. So same position, lift those hips, and as we kick the right leg, we'll alternate, but we'll start with the right. As we kick that leg out, we're gonna dip and bring it back. Other side, dip and kick and bring it back. Dip and bring it back. Dip. Keep going. Woo! Feel it. Keep going. And dip and kick. How about two more? That means one more each side. Kick and kick and dip. Woo! Now, if your triceps are not burning after that, and you don't need this. You have triceps of steel. All right. Maybe take a little tricep stretch. Grab an elbow and gently pull. And grab the other side. Pull and breathe. One more here. This one is going to actually work your back too. Your kind of back to the shoulders, but it'll also work your backside as well. So we're gonna keep the feet flat on the mat. We're going to push through one arm, one side first. So I'm gonna start pushing through the right hand. This is my right arm. And then we're gonna reach back with our left arm as we lift our hips. So we reach over, and we can just bring that arm between the legs, okay? So we reach for 8, 7, push into that hand on the mat. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, oof. And last one, reach. And you can probably hear my knees cracking. So that's happened to you. Don't feel bad. Let's try the other side, right? Same thing, feet flat, hip distance apart, and they are parallel. It's the angle of this camera is making them look like they're not, but they are. And then we push and we reach over for 8, 7, just pushing those hips up as high as you can, 5, 4, almost there. Two more. 2. And last one. Push. And come back. Ooh. All right. We are almost done with this short little arm workout. We're going to go into back to planks. And we will end with some push-ups. But instead of just doing our standard shoulder push-ups, you know, change it up. Vary it so you will stay with it. That's one of the ways to stay with it, is to just do something different. So it's not always the same every time.
traveling push-ups, and we'll do a few of those. And I'm going to stay on my knees for this one, but you strong people out there, you can feel free to go to your toes. My arms are already tired. So shoulder push-ups, elbows pulling out. We go one, we step the hands over to the right, push up again. Step them again one more time over to the right, push up, and work your way back. Pushing up each time, traveling now to the left. Coming back towards the center, and feel free to do as many rounds as those of those as you would like. We can also do some diamond push-ups. You're gonna make your hands like a diamond. Index fingers together, thumbs together, and place them on the mat. Your elbows are going out wide as you do this. And then you push down and push back up. And this is actually going to work your upper back even more. Push and push for just three, two, and one. Whew. Come back. Take a deep breath. All right, one last variation. And we're going to go into downward dog for it. So go ahead and plant those hands, tuck the toes, lift the hips. Feel solid before you go anywhere else here. So spread your fingers widely. Feel the weight of the palms. Press those heels back. And then we add a push-up here. So see, I'm pushing up with the upper body. I'm just bending the elbows. Head towards the mat. Chest towards the mat. A little downward dog push-up. It's not a big move. Pushing up for just three, two, and one. Drop those knees gently. Push back and relax. Turning those palms upwards to stretch out the arms. Maybe bringing the hands behind towards your feet. Or clasping them at the lower back and pulling them back overhead. Breathing deeply. And release. Go ahead and roll yourself up to a comfortable seated position. Take one arm across, pull that shoulder down. So you feel stronger already? I think I do. A little shaky, but stronger. And other arm. So the great thing about doing body weight exercises for your upper arms is that you are usually then working out another part of your body as well. So most of what we did involved the core and the back. Some good back strengthening. All right, guys, thank you for joining me, and stay tuned for more videos. And please let me know how you're doing with your workouts. Send me a picture, even a photo, because I miss you and I'd love to see your faces. Thanks.